नेक्स्ट इज बॉटम ट्यूब वी डिस्कस्ड, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज बेलोस। सो व्हाट इज बेलोस? सो लेट मी ड्रॉ द बेलोस स्ट्रक्चर। So there are some convolutions or convolutions, and this is the, here the deflection will take place. So it is connected to a pointer of this kind. So this is the pointer. So write D ref, just moment clicking D ref, and L E double F. This length is called L E double F, and this pressure will be applied from this side. D ref is called the reference diameter, and LEFF is called the effective length or the actual length. When the pressure is not applied at that time, what is the effective length? So you see, and these are called convolutions. Convolutions, okay. So these are the convolutions. You see, when the pressure is applied, this convolutions will expand and this LEFF will expand. As it will expand, this gear will move. Here some gear technique will be there, okay. Due to this pointer will move in these two directions and mechanical output will be obtained. How to convert it to electrical form, that I will discuss later. Now just take it like this. The bellows elements can be considered to be made of cascaded capsules as shown in the figure. Okay, these are like cascaded capsules. This is one capsule, this is another capsule, this is another capsule. So these capsules are cascaded, connected one after one, and made these convolutions and converted to bellows. Okay. In fact, one method of manufacturing the bellows element is by fastening the together several individual diaphragms. So number of diaphragms may also be connected or cascaded, and then you may obtain the bellows. That is also possible. Okay, means how to construct this. Okay. Now next point is the bellows elements basically is one piece expansible, compressible, collapsible, axially flexible member. It consists of several convolutions or foldings or folds, you can say. So there are several convolutions. Now it is usually formed in one continuous operation from the thin seamless tube into deeply folded or corrugated unit by either a hydraulic or mechanical method. So in this way we can make the bellows. It may be made from continuous piece of thin metals. So these are the how to make the bellows. Now come to the main point. The generally accepted methods of manufacturing bellows elements are by tuning from a solid stock of metal, by soldering or welding stamped annular rings rolling a tube and by hydraulically forming hadron tubing. For now you come to the construction. For n convolutions total n minus 1 convolutions are active. So you see this is one convolution, another convolution, another convolution. In this manner, if total number of n convolutions are there, then only n minus 1 convolutions are active. This point you remember. Okay. Based on construction, I will not ask any question, but you remember these things. These are very important things. Then the open side of a bellow element is rigidly held to instrument casing. Okay, the open side of a bellow element is rigidly held to instrument casing. So this part will be connected to the casing. Then the effective length or active length is smaller than actual size because of rigid fixing. So the actual length will be the actual length or active length is smaller than the actual size. Okay, as convoluted bellows elements is pressurized, the pointer connected to other end of the other end, this one. Next, the compound action of bending and tension operates the elastic member in general. The displacement of bellows element is given by D equal to, again it is a empirical formula, 0.453 PBN dm square 1 minus eta square to the power half mean square root whole divided by et cube, where I will not write everything. P equal to pressure, P equal to radius of each corrugation. Corrugation means it is called convolution or corrugation. So B equal to radius of each corrugation. Small n is the number of semicircular corrugation, total number of things. T equal to thickness of the wall. Dm equal to mean diameter. Capital E equal to modulus of elasticity. Nu equal to Poisson's ratio. Now this is one empirical formula. There are several empirical formulas. The deflection of bellow when supported or opposed by spring. If the this bellow is connected to a spring, inside this a spring connection is also there, then it is given by small d equal to P AE divided by KB plus KS, where small d equal to deflection of bellows, P equal to applied pressure, AE, this is actually AE, means it is suffix, AE, AE, effective area of bellows, then KB equal to force constant or spring rate of bellows, Ks equal to force constant or spring rate of the retaining spring. Okay, means why it is called a retaining spring, because when the P will be applied, it will be pressurized, then when the P is released, it must come to its original position, so this spring will come into the picture, the Ks. Okay, now again you see another expression. If the bellows assembly is to be operated by some electrical switch or some mechanism at its free end, then it will be given as if there is some electrical operation must be there for operating the bellows, then this P will be directly given by F plus ds, kb plus ks whole divided by ae. Here F equal to the force required to operate the switch or mechanism, ds equal to deflection required to operate switch mechanism, okay. And the other things I have already told, KB equal to force constant or spring rate of the bellows, and KS equal to the force constant or spring rate of the retaining spring. Now you just understand, this K is due to the, directly due to the spring. This spring you may draw in this way also, okay, whatever you can draw. And KB is its own property due to the bellows property, how the restoring force it can apply by its own, okay. Now the next point is material used. Material of construction for bellows elements depend on the medium to which they are exposed, corrosive or non-corrosive, etc. Then bellows are commonly made up of brass, stainless steel, phosphor, bronze, mono and beryllium copper. Next, the general criteria for choosing a specific material for an elastic member specifically for bellows elements are range of the pressure, then hysteresis, failure or dynamic operation, corrosion and fabrication case. Next, for good strength of the element, carbon steel is selected. The next, for improved hysteresis properties, the choice lies between trumpet brass, phosphor bronze, silicon bronze, etc. Beryllium copper gives better dynamic performance. Then stainless steel is resistive to corrosion, and for easy fabrication, soft materials are sought after. The bellows advantages are high force delivered, moderate cost, adaptable for absolute and differential pressure, etc. Then good in the low to moderate pressure range. Disadvantages are need ambient temperature compensation, not suitable for high pressure, limited in the availability of metals, some tend to work harden, then required spring for accurate characterization. So these are some of the points about bellows. I think you have understood. Thank you.